with Mike Slagh is going to be moderated by Leslie Carstens. Now, Mike is a former bomb disposal officer and now the founder and CEO of Shift, a career advancement company for current and former U.S. military. In this talk, you can come learn how you can transition into your next career through the five-week Navigation Next 5 program, or have access to their hiring partners at the SkillBrigde Internship Initiative. So without further ado, here's Mike Slagh and Leslie Carstens.
Thanks, Hunter. And do we have, I don't actually see Mike.
I'm right here. Hey, Leslie.
Oh, you're there. Okay.
I'm on top here. All right. Good okay. to see you. Thanks for the intro, Hunter. Appreciate that.
Yeah. Thanks for being here. I so appreciate it. I was actually really excited for this talk. And to get it kicked off, I'd love to hear, you know, not just about Shift, which I definitely want to hear about, but also like what was behind, you know, the impetus and the motivation to start it.
Well, I appreciate the opportunity, Leslie, and for folks watching along the way, it's great to have the opportunity just to spend a little bit of time together. I'm really supportive of what Power to Fly is doing here, and a pretty crazy amount of really cool, insightful speakers from really diverse perspectives, but with this shared goal of creating workforces where veterans can really thrive. And so when you got a bunch of people with different perspectives but the same goal, that's when you get extraordinary outcomes. And so I really appreciate that opportunity. The story of Shift is pretty simple. We're living in a world right now where technology is touching everything that we're doing. It's accelerating the ways in which our work is changing. And so when I served in the military as a Navy EOD officer, I looked all around and I saw folks that were some of the most creative problem solvers I'd ever met, people that could do really hard things in the face of adversity. And that experience and perspective was colored by helping get a different technology company off the ground prior to my time in the Navy. And I looked around at the people I was working with side by side and the folks I was supporting. And I said, wow, these are the exact kind of people you need when you're trying to start something new, or you're trying to do something that hasn't been done before. And yet, I think one of the headwinds that our military community faces is you can't access an opportunity that's not visible to you. And so, I saw amongst the folks I was serving, just a really narrow perspective into what the full opportunity set, during active duty service and beyond, when you're trying to navigate, a 20 plus year post-military career, a lack of visibility into the full opportunity set. I think that problem, as technology accelerates what we do and brings a bunch of new industries online that haven't existed before, that problem is getting a little bit worse. And so that's why we think a company like Shift has to exist. And we're trying to build advancement opportunities at every phase. And whether you're on active duty service or beyond, our goal is to build a USAA size company in terms of scale, but also impact all around professional growth, career advancement, and getting connected to people who care about the same things as you. Is that what we're looking for, Leslie? The impetus to Shift?
Yeah, no, actually that was fantastic. And actually, I really liked when you hit on why it is that veterans face these headwinds coming into the workforce. I think we all have kind of a picture of what that is, but obviously you've got more insight and you touched on some of the reasons, the technology gap or a perceived technology gap, because obviously people aren't going to come out and necessarily code in a week or two, but I do a little bit of job coaching and I have to remind people like some of those skills, I'm like time out, right? That's a 2-hour, Udemy course, right? I'm like, that's not a blocker, but I'd be really interested to get your perspective on what are the other things that factor into that when, veterans come out? And as you say, you and I look at them and we see, we see the potential and the value they can add, but they don't see it. And, what do you think, what are some of the other reasons that are behind that?
Yeah, I think that, my perspective is completely framed from the perspective, I look back, serving, 10 years ago, and I separated from the military 5 years ago. But just think about that time period, in our lives 10 years ago, there really wasn't, cloud technology. There was really no such thing as a data science industry or artificial intelligence. Crypto was like this nascent idea, fintech, you know, and I could go on and on and on. You know, Uber Eats didn't exist, and all these things that have this huge, huge impact on our lives. You know, that world just 10 years ago is fundamentally unrecognizable to us today. And so, you know, if we believe that the rate of change in how technology is impacting the kinds of work that we do, if we actually think that that rate of change is actually accelerating, what does that mean? That means that maybe only 5 years from now, that same unrecognizable world is what we're living in. And so I think about, you know, the challenges, you know, or maybe the headwinds that veterans are facing, they're evolving a little bit, you know, just like, you know, the workforce is needing to evolve to meet new needs, you know, in the very near term future. And so when I think about, you know, the type of headwinds that veterans are facing, they might be a little bit different than the type of narratives that we've been hearing for 5 years or 10 years or 20 years. You know, we believe at Shift, and I'm sure everybody on this call today, that military experience is valuable, that it's important, that it has something to offer. Yet it remains largely a black box by many Americans. And so one of the trends that we're seeing is it's less preconceived notions or bias, you know, against military, you know, backgrounds these days. And it's more, I think it's interesting, but I literally have no idea where to put you in our workforce,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And so, you know, the private sector and the way that work works, it's changing so fast. And yet there's so few opportunities to see what great looks like while you're on active duty service, unless you're in like a specific kind of job, or you get to do a fellowship program, or you're doing like some side projects. And then I'll just quickly say, like, you know, if I'm going to talk about, you know, the headwinds, and that might be a little bit different than how others frame it, I got to talk about the tailwinds as well. Like, what's actually some positive trends that we're seeing? What's the opportunity that we can potentially capture? The positive trends are that we're living in a moment in time where creating a diverse workforce that represents the rich diversity of the customers that you serve is, you know, within the top priorities of pretty much every executive team and fast-growing company in the world. You know, the military represents the most diverse workforce on the planet. You know, it's made of people from every city and state, you know, every walk of life. And then the other two things that, you know, we're seeing is that one, it's really hard for folks in the private sector right now to continuously evolve and continuously learn new skills. Like, it's exhausting for many folks, you know, even in these like relatively staid professions, like if you're a lawyer or an accountant, you know, your whole job has changed like 50% in just the last 5 years. You have new platforms, you got a text message with founders, you got to generate leads in new ways. And so what I think the thing that veterans don't necessarily realize is like, that's us. We have had to continuously evolve over, you know, to stay relevant in our career paths for the last 20 years. Then the last, you know, sort of, you know, tailwind that we're seeing is in the world that just completely shifted under our feet over the last 18 months, right? Resilience is incredibly important. You know, having people on your side when strategy changes, or maybe you're operating in a strategy vacuum, you need people that, you know, aren't going to quit, but actually going to help bring everybody up around them when things get really difficult. So you get the military, these folks that are resilient, they're happy to learn new things. And it's a really diverse workforce. You know, those are the trends that I'm seeing.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Well said. And I think you hit on something really interesting, which is that, you know, employers just have a big question mark about, you know, how best to utilize their skills. So what would your advice be to either employers looking to hire veterans, but, you know, as you say, not really sure what to do with them, or to the veterans when they're engaging with those employers, you know, so that they can get more prescriptive about, you know, here's where I fit potentially?
Yeah, I think, you know, sometimes I get asked, I guess, like, what are, you know, to get kind of a tactical example here, like what are some best practices that we'd recommend when you are answering like an interview question, like something you hear, you know, every single time, like, tell me a little bit about yourself. And the thing that is important to remember, and one of the ways that we see veterans, hold themselves back a little bit. If you're sitting across the table from somebody who's they're interviewing you, right? They are genuinely curious about military service. They just don't necessarily know if there's a fit here, or if you have, maybe the required industry specific context to onboard into this new industry and get up to speed quickly. The thing that is difficult when you have broad capabilities, right? And I see it, talk to a lot of folks who are transitioning out and they're like, hey, I did these very strategic partnerships with literally the generals within a foreign military halfway across the world. And I think I'm like, whoa, like this is somebody who could be, tremendous in federal business development or, onboarding new technologies to our militaries or our allies. Then in the same sentence, they'll say, and I manage, one of the most complex, logistical maneuvers, getting 15 people and $15 million a year from this location to that location. And now all of a sudden you've almost got like split personalities. Right. So what we have to remember is that we are only to others, the version of our stories that we share with them. Right. And like, with the opportunity set expanding rapidly, hiring is just like an emergency right now. You don't hire because we have a few billets that opened up and we need to get a few more people at our unit. Like in the private sector, we open up job requisitions when we literally don't think we're going to get the work done to accomplish what we said we were going to accomplish, what we're committed to. And so the stories that cut through like a knife are the ones that are specific. And it can be kind of daunting if you're like, well, I could do this, I could do that, I could do this. I don't want to narrow my total opportunity set. But that's really the thing that holds veterans back, is helping to communicate exactly where they fit, within a workforce. And if that story is not really resonating or it's not working, it's okay to have a couple of stories in the market. We're impossibly complex as human beings. And especially with a group of folks who have very broad capabilities, every opportunity we pursue, we have to show this like narrow version of ourselves in order to really cut through.
Yeah. You're exactly right. And, cause it's so psychological. It's 20% mechanics and 80% psychology, like everything else. And I read about a project that you guys have called Navigating Next, which I think goes to this idea of like the veterans supporting each other to help, with self-esteem and confidence. And I'd love to hear more about Navigating Next.
Navigating Next is this 5-week long cohort-based course that helps folks, essentially answer that question of, what's next for me? Not only to understand what the full opportunity set could potentially hold, but then once you kind of, that plan for the future comes into focus, how to pursue it with success. And, we go through this process of spending 5 weeks of time with a group of about 25 to 40 people at a time, to figure out, okay, what's really important to me? How do we want to create impact in sort of the remaining weeks on the calendar, sort of what we foresee in our professional career? The pursuing it with success, so a big thing that we do is helping folks understand what great looks like across industry. And, we think that, this is going to be like an incredibly important skill to have in the future as sort of new industries, explode out of thin air. We have to be able to understand what great looks like in a hiring process. What are the things that, the folks across industry are really keying in on or looking for? And when you do this course and you go through this experience with a number of other folks, it sounds kind of simple, but you can watch a group of other people's interview prep take place. You can hear other folks, their insights. And it gives us leverage where at the same time, we're connecting people to a group of others who have really diverse perspectives, but they have this shared goal of figuring out what's next. That's really where the magic is. And when you have, of course, diverse perspectives, shared goals, you get to these uncommon outcomes on the other side. Really excited about Navigating Next, just because,
oh my gosh,
you look at the, of course, we look at the first party testimonials and we look at some of the outcomes that are taking place. But, we realize that, career transition is hard for anybody right? Whether you're a senior executive or, you know, this is the first time you're ever interviewing, you know, for a private sector job. And so being able to go across industries is something that, you know, as many, many Americans are going to have to do over the next 10 years as sort of technology changes the way that work works. So if you're interested in figuring out what does the future of career change look like, the military just happens to be this great place to focus in on, a great place to start, because we all have to do it, you know, and we've all had to do it for the last 100 years.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Well, and I, you know, what I loved about, as you were describing the Navigating Next program, I kept thinking that it also would sort of normalize the challenges that they're facing. Because if, you know, especially the last 2 years, right, we're all in our houses and you get, you know, you just kind of think it's just me, everybody else is having all this success. And then when you realize, oh, okay, it's just this hard, just that mindset shift, I think can be huge. But there's another program that it sounds like you guys are running called SkillBrigde, which I think is an internship program, which also sounded amazing. So yeah, I think the audience would love to hear about that.
And Navigating Next, you know, that really helps you understand, you know, what motivates me? What are the things that I care about? What's an area of the workforce that, you know, maybe is emerging and nobody really knows that much about? And how do I go and create impact in that part of the workforce? What does great look like? And then SkillBrigde is a really great way to go out and try it out to make sure that that is a great fit. SkillBrigde is a Department of Defense initiative that's been around for a few years, but it's kind of picking up steam right now. And it's really exciting because when service members are approved to participate, you know, they can spend up to their last month, you know, up to the last 6 months of active duty service. And it usually works out, you know, 3 to 6 months of actually, you know, directly interning at an employer prior to separation from military service. And even if it isn't a great mutual fit at the end of that internship, you know, you now have this, you know, set, you know, really unique piece of commercial experience on your resume that really differentiates you in the job market. But we actually see them far, 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 far more often than not. You know, you actually get to accelerate into that full-time opportunity and you convert, you know, to a full-time teammate, and you've gotten all the hard stuff out of the way first. Like you just spent, you know, 3 months getting your housing situation figured out, you know, building rapport with your future teammates. So you're essentially like the most up to speed teammate, you know, day one of, you know, technical, you know, full-time employment with this new opportunity. One of the things go ahead.
That is fantastic. No, I was just applauding that. That's amazing. That's fantastic. Please keep going.
I was just going to share one of the things that we announced on Veterans Day. So, you know, we have been able to place a number of, you know, these SkillBrigde opportunities within emerging technology companies, in technology companies that are often backed by, you know, this class of investors called venture capitalists. And, you know, venture capitalists, you know, they're taking the most risky bets, and they are the, you know, the type of investors that will invest in the companies that are going to space and doing manufacturing, in low Earth orbit. They're the type of companies that are investing in self-driving cars and sort of reinventing fintech and the crypto economy. So within this group of opportunities, it's not necessarily for everybody, but we see this huge opportunity for veterans to come in and be part of these new industries, because we go out into these ambiguous, kind of fractured environments where things aren't really well figured out. And maybe a common, you know, perception about military service, it's a very hierarchical, SOP-driven type of career experience. But how it actually plays out is, you know, veterans come from a really diverse workforce. They are continuously learning new things, and they are really, really resilient. That's exactly what the modern workforce needs. Like, that's exactly who you need on your side when you're trying to start something new. And so on Veterans Day, we announced that we have a consortium of about 50 leading venture capital firms who are actively syndicating SkillBrigde opportunities via Shift to their portfolio of companies that they've invested in. So we want to build this really significant bridge between military service and the Department of Defense and emerging technology, whether somebody's on active duty service or building a really impactful post-military career.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. That's fantastic. That's where the rubber meets the road. And by the way, there's some questions in the chat. Somebody was asking about if they wanted to learn more about the Navigating Next project, how would they do that?
Yeah, our website's shift.org, and I think you can do that /navigating-next, or you'll just, if you click on career transition at the top of the site, you'll see the Navigating Next overview. And then I also saw Nima asked about interview practice. Do we also handle software engineering technical interviews? We do. We have a network of employers who you can essentially request, interview prep on our mentorship platform. And then we can also, connect you to hiring managers for practice interviews as well.
I love it. I love it. Yeah, you just get that muscle memory. So if you had to say, one or two things to veterans transitioning out of the military, what would you wish that they knew when they were coming out that having worked with so many, now successful veteran, but people who've come out of the military and been successful moving into the corporate world, or as you say, some of the startups.
Yeah, I think that when you look around what is happening in the private sector, the first job that you do after the military is certainly not your forever job. We actually are seeing kind of this trend towards, there's this group of people that are increasingly taking on almost like a portfolio life, right? It's so special when you can use your skills and the things that you're great at to create impact across different industries. Of course, we want to live in a world someday where when you transition across industries, your career is actually advanced, rather than held back. That's the world that we live in today. And so, but when you think about, the types of things that could really speed you up, when you're trying to figure out what's next, there's kind of like only two things that I recommend. There's a lot of things that you can do, but the two things that we've seen that just have the most tremendous impact are, one, you got to find your people. You have to find people who are moving with you through this process, people that got different perspectives from you, different military communities, people who don't, who necessarily, maybe they support military service and they're trying to figure out how to plug in. You have to find those folks who have the same goals as you, but they come from different perspectives. You hear a lot about finding a mentor, right? I think it's important, but almost more important is finding those peers, who are in the trenches themselves. And they may have just had that conversation that you're about to have next week. They had it last week, right? So you got to find your people. Number two is, in order to see what great looks like across industries and even figure out what's even going on and what's possible across industries, start to think about how might I take on a little bit of project work or a little bit of consulting work or do a SkillBrigde internship. Everything about military service has relevance in a different part of the workforce. You may be doing, I could probably name like a bunch of different military jobs. And if you go on to a number of different gig platforms or consulting platforms, you can start doing a little bit of work to figure out, hey, where do my skills apply and where can I create value on the other side? So you got to start doing some, even if you're doing a project for fun, for yourself. Just doing that really helps you figure out what could be possible.
Yeah. Plus, it looks great on a resume and starts to answer some of those questions that employers might have about, how do we leverage this person? Yeah. Any big surprises for you in kind of getting shift off the ground?
I think that whenever you're trying to like build a company and build a team and you have an ambitious mission, that it feels like there's a new surprise or something to deal with like every single day. I think that probably it may not sound like a surprise, but the thing that has constantly wowed me is, when we design our experiences or we allocate our time towards activities that are much more, result in a very deep relationship versus something that's transactional, that deep relationship that's formed, whether it's with a hiring partner, with a venture capital investor, whether you know a teammate or a veteran that we're helping change careers, you know, that when we have that relationship, it's almost impossible to characterize how much the value of that relationship can compound through time. Like when I was leaving the military and trying to figure out, all right, what am I going to do next? And I helped somebody get a job the first time. And it was just because I had an internal referral. I knew somebody who was a hiring manager. It was pretty easy for me to do. But then, you know, that feeling when they got the thing that they might not have had access to otherwise, I was like, oh, that's what I do. That's what I love. Right. And so, you know, we hear a lot about, oh, well, this solution doesn't scale to the moon, or it's not, you know, technology enabled enough. You know, technology exists to help give these touch points to make the experience of transition, you know, much more seamless. But when we sort of optimize towards these cohort-based experiences, like Navigating Next or like Defense Ventures, you know, those relationships are so valuable 3, 4, 5 years into the future. The same is true for just keeping up with your network and the people, you know, and you find your peers, you know, who are sort of attacking the same goals.
Yeah. Yeah. That's such great advice. And, you know, I'm sure there's a lot of people on the phone who are going to be looking to, you know, learn more about, you know, not just Navigating Next and SkillBrigde, but, you know, all the programs you have. So other than your website, are there any places you would encourage them to check out?
Yeah, I think I think one of the things we didn't talk to as much today, which is totally fine, but you know, what happens if you know what great looks like, you know, years before you transition from the military? What happens if you are right out at the fringe of emerging technology and you have all these relationships, you know, within, you know, technology companies, venture-backed startups, venture capital firms? It almost eliminates transition because you can't overstate how important it is to have access to a world that you don't currently live in. And so when you have access, and that means like, I know that I can get an internal referral to any company I want. If I email their investor a 2-sentence blurb and my resume is attached, they're gonna forward it along, you know, to the founding team. Like that type of stuff, you know, it kind of clicks. And if you have that experience, you know, years before you transition, think about how much anxiety that relieves as well. That's one of the things that we, you know, we think our Defense Ventures Fellowship accomplishes as well. And you know, this is for active duty members who are actually trying to bring the best commercial technology into the Department of Defense. It has this dual purpose where they're not worried about transition. They're focused on the goal of bringing the DoD into the 21st century. It's exciting.
Yeah. We'll see. Yeah. Yeah, get a running start at it. It was actually a great question from Nima in the chat, if you want to take a crack at that.
Yeah, there are a ton of course options out there. I think that there are some of these skills that exist when, you know, if you look at a bunch of different, you know, a given batch of job descriptions, you know, you might see something like, you know, SQL proficiency is highly preferred, SQL proficiency is, you know, required. And you can get really proficient in SQL with, you know, some focused practice and a couple of projects in just a matter of weeks. And so I think that there are some of these skills or credentials that really do make a difference. And you can figure out, you know, which ones make a difference, you know, by just looking at job descriptions. Like we have the answers to the test. But, you know, my caution would be to really focus on the ones that you are seeing in the modern workforce. You know, it can be almost feel like the easy option to just knock out certification after certification and say, well, I did all the work, right? It's equally important to go out and actually build relationships, do projects, you know, actually demonstrate your capabilities in these skills. You can do that with SkillBrigde. You can do that with a fellowship type of program. And so there has to be this balance between projects and actual, you know, skills. We're not, as you know, employers are not looking to hire a bag of skills, right? And that's not who we are. We're these impossibly complex human beings. And we have to prove ourselves and share that version of our story that resonates, you know, with the other side. We are only the version of our story to others that we share with them.
Yeah, I love it. Well, this has been so awesome. And I am definitely going to go check out Shift in more detail. So I appreciate your time. Thank you. And thanks for the work you do.
Thank you, Leslie. It's been my pleasure. I really appreciate it.
Take care.